Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Trupti and welcome to my YouTube channel Enjoy Biochemistry. In the video lecture series on molecular biology, today we are going to learn about mutation, its types and consequences. What is mutation? Mutation is the replacement of nitrogenous base with another in one or both the strands of DNA or addition or deletion of a base pair. And this replacement leads to permanent changes in the nucleotide sequence of DNA. The mutations in germ cells are transmitted to the next progeny and may give rise to various inherited diseases. And mutations in somatic cell, they are not transmitted to the progeny, but they are important in the causation of cancers and some congenital malfunctions. And mutagens are the substances which can induce mutations, and they are collectively known as mutagens. And these mutagens can be chemicals, radiations, and viruses. What are the various causes of mutations? The first cause is error in proofreading during DNA replication. We know that DNA polymerase corrects the mismatch during replication by proofreading, and this excision of mismatched base occurs by 3' to 5' exonuclease activity of this DNA polymerase, and by that activity the correct base is added. But if the proofreading is not effective, then the legend remains in the DNA molecule and it leads to mutation. So this is the first cause, that is error in proofreading during DNA replication. The second important cause is if there are errors in the DNA repair, it can also result in mutation. The third cause of mutation is errors in DNA recombination, and this DNA recombination occurs by translocation and rearrangement of genes or chromosome crossover. So if this recombination is defective, it can lead to mutation. The fourth cause is spontaneous change in DNA. And it can occur due to deamination of cytosine to uracil or spontaneous depurination. Various environmental factors are also responsible for mutations, for example, chemical mutagens. These mutagens alter DNA bases or structure of DNA. For example, base analogs, alkylating agents, intercalcating agents, nitrous acid, that is deaminating agent, hydrazines, aflatoxins. So all are the examples of chemical mutagens. Even the irradiation, ultraviolet light or infrared radiations can also alter the structure of DNA and can lead to mutation. So there are five important causes of mutations: errors in the proofreading during DNA replication, errors in DNA repair, errors in the recombination, if there is any spontaneous change in DNA, or due to various environmental factors like chemical mutagens and UV light or irradiations. What are the types of mutations? So mutation can be of two types, that is base substitution or point mutation, and second type is frame shift mutation. So what is point mutation? There is replacement or change in a single base, so it is called as point mutation. This point mutation can be of transition type or transversion type. So what happens in the transition type of mutation? It is the replacement of purine by purine, means purine is changed to other purine or pyrimidine is changed to other pyrimidine. For example, there can be interconversion of thymine to cytosine or adenine to guanine. This is called as transition. Now what is transversion? In the transversion, there is change from a purine to either of the two pyrimidines, or change from a pyrimidine into either of two purines. For example, the change from thymine to adenine or guanine, or change of cytosine to adenine to guanine, or change of adenine to thymine to cytosine, or change of guanine to thymine and cytosine. So this is a transversion mutation. So point mutation is of two types, that is transition and transversion. What are the various effects or consequences of point mutation? There can be three effects: silent mutation, missense mutation, and nonsense mutation. So in the silent mutation, there will be no detectable effect, and it occurs due to degeneracy of code. What is degeneracy? That is the coding of some amino acid by more than one codon. We know that except for tryptophan and methionine, all amino acids are coded by more than one codon, and most of the codon they differ only on their third nucleotide. So if the change occur in the third nucleotide, that it will not lead to any detectable effect. And because of Wobble hypothesis or Wobble phenomena, the translation of a codon is least sensitive to change in the third position. For example, arginine is coded by CGA and CGG. So if there is a mutation of adenine to guanine and the codon change from CGA to CGG, it won't affect the protein because both of these codons specify arginine. So there will be no detectable effect due to the silent mutation. So this is the first consequence of point mutation, that is silent mutation. The other effect of point mutation is nonsense effect. What happens here? There is conversion of an amino acid codon to a stop codon or nonsense codon. And as the stop codon is encountered during the process of translation, it leads to premature termination of polypeptide chain, which is usually non-functional. For example, in beta thalassemia, beta chain of hemoglobin, the codon 17 is changed from UGG, which codes for tryptophan, to UGA, that is the nonsense codon, and it leads to premature termination of a polypeptide chain. So this is the nonsense mutation. What is missense mutation and missense effect? So here in this case, a different amino acid is incorporated at the corresponding site in a protein molecule. Now, what are the various types of missense effect or missense mutation? It can be acceptable, partially acceptable, or unacceptable. Now, let's see the examples of acceptable, partially acceptable, and unacceptable missense mutation. So what happens in the adult hemoglobin beta chain? In the acceptable missense mutation, it changes to HB hikari. At 61 position, lysine is changed to aspargine, and lysine is coded by two amino acids here, AAA and AAG. So the third nucleotide A and G, they can change to adenine, can change to uracil or cytosine, and if guanine is changed to uracil or cytosine, the lysine at 61 position now becomes aspargine and HBA becomes HB hikari. So it is the acceptable missense mutation. What is the example of partially acceptable missense mutation? Here in this case, adult hemoglobin or HBA beta chain, it changes to HBS beta chain. So because at the 6th position on beta chain, glutamate is changed to valine. Here glutamate is coded by GAA and GAG, so there is change in the second base, that is A is changed to U, so GAA becomes GUA and GAG becomes GUG. So this is the partially acceptable missense mutation. Now the unacceptable missense mutation is that in the alpha chain of hemoglobin, it changes to HBM, that is the Boston hemoglobin. Here on the alpha chain, on 58th position, histidine is changed to tyrosine. So here in this case, CAU and CAC codes for histidine, and there is change in the first nucleotide base, that is C is changed to U. So now it becomes UAU and UAC. So histidine is changed to tyrosine and HBA becomes HBM. So it is the unacceptable missense mutation. Frameshift mutation can be of two types. First is insertion type of frameshift mutation and second is deletion type of frameshift mutation. What happens in the insertion type? There is insertion of one or two nucleotides into a gene, and it leads to distortion of a reading frame, and further it leads to garbled amino acid sequence distal to that insertion, and further it leads to termination of polypeptide chain. And it results in non-functional, prematurely terminated protein. With the help of this example, let's understand how insertion of base leads to premature termination of polypeptide chain and distortion of reading frame. So this is the normal polypeptide chain. These are the various codons which code for this amino acid of this polypeptide chain. If there is insertion of one cytosine here at this point after GCC, so this, if C is added here, it becomes CUC. So now UCU codes for serine, but now CUC codes for leucine. So after this point, the amino acid, the reading frame is distorted and the amino acid sequence is garbled. And there is now the stop codon is encountered here, and there is premature termination of polypeptide chain. So because of this insertion, there is premature termination of polypeptide chain. There are various diseases associated with this insertion type of mutation, and the examples of Huntington's disease, Fragile X syndrome, etc. Second type of frameshift mutation is deletion type. In the deletion type, there is deletion of a nucleotide or nucleotides from a coding strand of a gene. It leads to altered reading frame on messenger RNA, which further leads to alteration in sequence of amino acid in a protein molecule, and there is garbled translation of messenger RNA distal to that nucleotide deletion. And if the stop codon is encountered, it leads to non-functional prematurely terminated protein. This is the example of frameshift mutation deletion type. This is the normal version. This is the polypeptide chain. Now what happens if there is deletion of one base, that is uracil? So if uracil is deleted from here, it becomes CUU and it codes for leucine. And distal to this deletion, the amino acid sequence becomes garbled. Now if there is deletion of three bases, for example UGC, which codes for cysteine, so the whole frame is distorted now, and that particular polypeptide chain will lack that particular amino acid. For example, in case of cystic fibrosis, because of such deletion, there is mutation in the phenylalanine at 508 position. And it leads to this important serious condition, that is cystic fibrosis, which occurs due to this deletion type of frameshift mutation. What is suppressor mutation and suppressor transfer RNA? So if the transfer RNA is abnormal, if there is mutation in the anticodon arm of transfer RNA, then what will happen? This abnormal tRNA can bind to mutated codons, and it lead to suppression of missense or nonsense effect of both point and frameshift mutations. And such tRNA is called as suppressor tRNA, and such mutation in tRNA, they are called as suppressor mutations. What is read-through mutation? So if there is mutation in the stop codon, what will happen? There will be coding of a new amino acid, and the polypeptide chain will be longer than the normal polypeptide chain until it encounters the next stop codon. And the anticodon arm of tRNA will read through that mutated stop codon, and that's why it is called as read-through mutation. And this can occur by point mutation, frameshift mutation, or suppressor mutation. The example of this read-through mutation is mutation in the alpha chain of hemoglobin, which leads to alpha thalassemia. So for example, normally what happens in the alpha chain at 142 codon, it is normally UAA. So the alpha globin chain length is 141 amino acid long. But now what happens if there is mutation in the stop codon? It can lead to formation of this longer polypeptide chain having this 172 amino acids. So this 172 amino acid, there can be the amino acid which can be at 142 position can be glutamine, lysine, glutamate, or serine. So if the codon is CAA, there will be glutamine, and that HB type will be constant spring type. If alpha codon at 142 is AAA, it is eukaryote type of hemoglobin, and the amino acid will be lysine. So in the sealed rock HB type, the codon will be GAA and the amino acid will be glutamate. In the Coiadora HB type, the codon will be UCA and amino acid will be serine. So this is the effect of read-through mutation, when normally the polypeptide chain should be of 141 amino acid length, but it is now longer than the usual one. It is 172 amino acid polypeptide chain. So this is called a read-through mutation. The mutations may be non-lethal, but it may alter the regulatory control, and such mutation in the somatic cell altering the regulatory control may result in uncontrolled cell division leading to cancer. As some of the mutations may lead to cancer, any substance causing increased mutation can also increase the possibility of cancer, and that's why all mutagens may be considered as carcinogenic. Mutations are not always lethal, they can be beneficial too. For example, the examples of beneficial mutations are in case of disease like malaria, the mutation is HBC mutation and it can occur in the population of sub-Saharan Africa. So in this area there is higher rate of mutated hemoglobin, that is HBC, and those with the hemoglobin C, they are much less susceptible to malaria. So this is the beneficial mutation for the population of sub-Saharan Africa where malaria is endemic. Second type of beneficial mutation is for the disease HIV. So if the mutation is in the CCR5, that is HIV receptor, in some population with North European ancestry, this CCR5 gene is mutated. So there is inability for the HIV to bind to their cells and it leads to complete resistance to HIV. So this is the beneficial mutation for those people living in North European ancestry. The third example is heart disease. So if the mutation is in the APOA1 melano, so in certain people of Italy, this is APOA1 is mutated and it results in the efficient clearing of cholesterol from the blood and it leads to reduced risk of cardiovascular disease. So these are some examples of beneficial mutation. Let's summarize today's topic, that is mutation. Mutation is the permanent change in the nucleotide sequence of DNA. There can be two types of mutation, point mutation and frameshift mutation. Point mutation can be of transition type or transversion type. The various consequences of point mutation are silent mutation, missense mutation and nonsense mutation. And the missense mutation examples or the effects can be acceptable missense mutation. The example is HB Hikari. The partially acceptable missense mutation example is HBS. And unacceptable missense mutation example is HBM. Nonsense mutation, the example is thalassemia. The frameshift mutation is the second type of mutation, which can be of two types, insertion and deletion. Fragile X syndrome is a type of insertion type of frameshift mutation. Cystic fibrosis, thalassemia, these are the deletion type of frameshift mutations.